Hi, this is Raymond. In this video, I'm going to conduct a brake servicing, also inspection and removal of bearings, inspection and removal of all seal, mechanical seal. We'll have seal and also our differential shaft seal. So I have here my brake shoe and the brake assemblies. I have here also the wheel hub assembly ready to remove. So I'm ready to remove this one. I have here the seal, the bearing. So as you can see, already removed the other one bearing. Since I have removed already the other bearing, so the next thing I'm going to do is to remove first the mechanical seal and remove the other wheel bearing. So in working with this spec, that it's a little bit messy since we're dealing with grease. Again, here's the other bearing. So as we can see, it's really obvious that it's already contaminated. You can see a black or gray grease already. So we'll try to clean this later and conduct more further inspection. We can check for wear and also discoloration, signs of overheat. Well, I will put this one first here, or I can put this for cleaning, and also the other part. So here's our seal. So this one is the area where I push or make impact, so I can push this seal. Make sure I will not hit this area so it can damage our bearing. For our seals, for our seal, I have here for my inspection of seal. So it's obviously already, since there's already an entrance of contamination or foreign object inside, dust or any kinds of foreign that can contaminate our grease. So how did I know? It's for the color of our grease. From this color up to blackish or gray like color, so it means that our grease is contaminated. can be due to dust, and also probably the wear parts or particles of this brake shoe. Anyway, during the process, we will during the removal of brake shoe and the wheel hub assembly, so we have to also conduct inspection of bearing and seal. And also, upon inspection, we will clean this area. We will check for the leak. There's signs of damage, and also if it's a stiffness. So since this one is obviously defective, since I cannot demonstrate the installation for now, I can only show on how I installed this one. So upon installation, I will make sure that this area where our seal seated or fitted should be clean, free of debris. For example, I have this seal. I can put this one. Since I don't have a kit for bearing mechanical seal installer, so I have here my I made this one. It's almost the same function, the same procedure or mechanism. So I just have to make sure that I will sprouted like and perfectly the same diameter. And also I have here the area where I can impact, so I can equally put power on all sides of this all area of this seal. So for example, this one, okay. So you can see this one is not the seal, just a demonstration. Then I can put like this, I can hammer slowly, check if it is evenly pushed. But anyway, here's the example also of a seal, a new seal. So as you can see, a bit soft. There's no sign of damage, no kinks of the parts or the metal parts. So this one is the hub seal or the wheel hub seal. So I have here the other one. This one is for the, as you can see, this one. I have here the other seal. So this one is for our shaft. This one is to prevent the oil from our differential to exit and going to our wheel hub assembly, so we don't want any contamination here. It will also affect our braking system. So, and for this wheel hub seal, so since this one is also need to replace, I will show you how to remove this one. This one is easy to remove since this one has already a slot where I can make impact, then just make some I can use flat screw. The shaft seal removed. Upon installation also, I will make sure that I have the correct seal. Secondly, I will check also the area of this where I fit the seal or the shaft seal seat. Should be clean. Then just reverse the procedure, fit this perfectly, and you can use also our hand like that. If it's a little bit, we can make you can use a seal installer, or just you can also use our own procedure where you can push equally the seal. Just to make sure, I'm just making sure that it's not going to be damaged. So, for me, I'm gonna use a rounded, any type of round that fit perfectly the diameter of the seal. Now for our bearing, as you can see, it's full of, already full of this. Black-like grease, black-colored grease in bearing. To put this one separately, not to steal, not to just put anywhere. I can put this one here together with our bearing. Since we have removed already, we will also check our outer rays. I have read the outer rays. The inner part of our windlass is assembly. We can use rods. This race, so we will also inspect the sign of wear, if there's already damage, broken, or sign of overheat discoloration. So for this, this one still okay. There's no sign of wear. Very fine surface. We will flip and check the other side. Careful when servicing this one, it's a little bit use of power. Make sure we have our safety shoes and using the power hand gloves or cotton gloves. So, also in this area, we can also clean. And we're going to check the outer rays. So as you can see also, there's no sign of discoloration, no overheat, there's no sign of wear, there's no damage or broken. So we're going to do is we're going to check our bearing after we clean. We're going to clean this one first. And also how to, I will show you also how to remove this brake shoe. So since this one is very dusty already, so we can use face mask to protect ourselves. So since I am using a hydraulic lifter, so I can adjust the heights. That's why I'm using a seat. So I will be comfortable when I'm going to work. Another case, we're servicing outside, so we have to do like this and bend our knees. For the removal of this, I'm just going to lift this up. Remember the position of the spring, this one's inside, this one's ready.
put stuff here. We will complete all these parts later. This one,
as you can see, this is really well. The weird pattern, so we don't want to fully consume this one. This is the weird pattern.
This one here. And then, I'm going to show you how the steps I'm going to clip. So instead of using all high pressure air, this one's the steps I do. So since this one is very dusty, I can use this spray. So check how I do. I use all the control pressure. Control the dust. So I just have to make sure that I have my face mask with me. So instead of blowing it up with air, so I use water and use this spray. I will recycle this one also. Since our brain is invisible with water, so it's always clean with water and air. But inside this workshop, so we don't want to blow this dust up. This one is also bad for the health. Pause for a while. So I forgot to cover this one and put rugs where our skin then. Also the of our cylinder or brake cylinder, so we don't need to remove it. We are replacing it with you, we can retract this adjuster. Just use the next one, also this one. Oil for this area, since we sprayed water, so it will be easier. So the next step, after we have been ready our brake cylinder and the area of our brake assemblies, so we will clean now the area of our bearings. First, I can use this one for the removal. As you can see, this is where our seal seated, or the lip that touches. This one is for our bearing, inner outer race of our inner bearing, and this one here is for outer bearing to make sure to leave this area, especially this area. For my rods, I can use since we have already cleaned the area, we can put grease. So this grease is recommended for really good, it's not like the other grease. It's a bit low viscosity. You can apply this area. Highly recommended to use our installer, both seal and bearing. Also, I have here other bearing. This one is a seal type ball bearing, also like this bearing. When fitting this one, we're going to fit the outer diameter. We'll use our bearing installer and push it to our, for example, pulleys or where it fitted. Unlike our wheel bearing, will be inserted here and push the end race. After cleaning our bearing, so we'll conduct further inspection here. I cannot see, or I don't see any sign of wear or damage. Usually the damage will be this roller bearing housing,
also you can see also in some that there's a damage of this bearing or ruler. And also for the inner rays and the contact area, it's perfectly it's good. So this time I'm going to repack this one. In repacking, it's recommended to use also if available the this heater or the machine or the tools that used to push only to put grease. But I will show the procedure I do. So I'll do manually. So I can use this one rubber glove, so make sure that it's free of contamination or clean. I can use this soft part of my palm. I will put here the grease in my hand, so make sure that it's clean and free of contamination, also our bearing and also our hand. So what will I do is I'll simply press this one in this area. As you can see, there's a small area in here and a bit big space in here, so I can push the grease, for example, like this. So you can feel the entry of our the grease inside our bearing. So our aim here is to put grease not just in the outer side or the outer part of our bearing, but also the inner side. So continue doing this procedure. So for example, I can see already the portion of the piece. So as you can see in this area, this one, there's already grease coming. The one he induced from here is going out already in here. So we can just continue to the process. So this is how I manually put grease on our wheel bearing. So I can put also a slight impact, so I can just make sure that it's free of contamination. So we don't want any contaminants in our grease and bearing. after the repacking and cleaning of our cleaning and repacking of our bearing, so we're going to place it in a clean and nice container so we can isolate the parts, as we have already put grease already together with the other parts. So for example, this nut and the lock washer. So that's it for my bearing inspection. For the installation, it's ready to just insert it and apply preload, as I have demonstrated earlier. I can put using torque wrench, or I can just apply it manually also. But recommended torque wrench, I usually 200 foot pounds, and then retract or loosen the nut again. Continue, tighten, then loosen. Torque in 50 foot pounds. Loosen it, and then make a loose at least 1/4, 1/6 turn or 1/4 turn. So that's the perfect preload, especially for this heavy duty wheel bearing. So after the work, I have to make sure that this is how it looks like. It's a little bit of a messy, but we make sure that we're going to clean this one. Before putting back our hand tools, we can use rags. So after the work, we make sure that we're going to clean our area, secure the parts, isolate the machine well, so for the isolation of the machine, I've already removed the power supply upon prior before working, and also I will put a tag that this one is under repair. So in our workshop we use this one, written in Arabic since we are in Saudi Arabia. So that it means that on the technician waiting for parts for under repair. So after conducting 5S, the next thing we're going to do is to conduct our findings and the parts we need. So I have here my